Silver has been trading sideways throughout January while gold rallied. Will silver start catching up to the yellow metal? Joining me today is Phil Streible, senior market strategist for Chicago-based RJO Futures. Phil, so good to see you again.
Yeah, thanks for having me.
So, Phil, last time we spoke, you said that when the gold-silver ratio hits 80, that's when you want to be in silver. We're now at 80 and a half. It's the highest in 2 years. What does this mean from a trading perspective?
Yeah, I think that's absolutely amazing, and I think it's a unique opportunity out there. Silver prices have been lagging gold for quite a while now, and I think that silver, it's due for its movement upwards. I wouldn't be surprised to see one of these 30 to 50 cent moves to the upside here. And really, with the volatility in the equity markets, the uncertainty, the volatility index also spiking, I would think that traders would be looking to rush into one of the metals. Some people that are a little bit more comfortable with gold may go into that, but I think the real opportunity does lie with silver.
Okay, and speaking about the volatility we've been seeing in the stock market, I've been asking a lot of guests this week why gold has not been rallying with all the the craziness we've seen. Phil, what's your take on it?
Yeah, it's interesting because, you know, people talk about safe havens, and it's really for each individual person, whether that's, you know, putting the money under the mattress, having it back in cash, going into the Swiss franc, Japanese yen. You know, everyone has a different opinion on what safe haven is. Now, we did see gold futures hold that 50-day moving average down at about 1308 today, and we saw a reaction back upwards there. Maybe we had to test the waters. There's a lot of liquidation going on. That's to drum up cash. I think that's why gold futures haven't been performing lately. People are so married to their equity positions, and a lot of people have been waiting for a correction in the equities to add to their positions. Just basic stocks people are going for, those old, you know, those old time stocks that have been around with the rising dividends. So people use that opportunity, that sell off there. They liquidated some of their gold holdings, and I think that they're starting to add to their equities.
Okay, so you're not worried about gold right here, is what I'm sensing.
If we get the close below the 50-day moving average, a two-day close below there, we may see a test of 1,300. If we test and we break through there, that 200-day moving average right around 1,290, that's going to be your key level there. So the way a trader could kind of play it is they could have like a put spread in place, like buy the 1,310, sell the 1,290. Now you've got that range covered there. And then if gold prices start to move up like they were performing better earlier and we start to push through some of these key levels, 1,330, I look at like a 1,350 call, because that's the level where I think if we break through that to the upside, we're going to retest those old highs.
Yeah, interesting. Actually perform better before the stock market sell-off. Phil Streible, thanks so much for your thoughts.
Yeah, thanks for having me.
And thank you for watching. We'll be back tomorrow.